Hi everyone, welcome again in this cyber security course. Today I came with one more video regarding cyber security. In this lesson we will see four parts. First we'll discuss about domain name system, then internet protocol, then uniform resource locator. After that we'll see about a top level domain. What are these points? These we will discuss in more detail. One by one we will see that. First we will see about what is a domain name system. Here on screen you can see domain name system. Domain name system is a system which converts letters into numbers. Not understood? Okay, I will explain. Can you remember 10 mobile numbers? Yes, it's very easy. Mummy mobile number, dad's mobile number, uncle mobile number. Like these many mobile numbers we can remember. But if those mobile numbers are more than 100, then no, it's not possible to remember. In the same way, domain name system helps us to remember these numbers. But not these numbers, we are going to remember all these things in different way. How? Simple. We can't remember all the mobile numbers, but we have a solution. We are saving those mobile numbers as a contact in our phone book. We are giving names to those mobile numbers. In that way, we are saving many mobile numbers. Here, this domain name system, this works for websites. On a screen, you can see one example I gave. That is what? Amazon.com. Amazon.com. We can remember spelling of Amazon.com, Google.com, Yahoo.com. Facebook.com. These are very easy, so we can remember, no problem. But if you are told to remember IP address of that, now you may ask me, sir, what is the IP address? See, here is the IP address. You can see this is IP address. This IP address is separated in four parts: 72.21.215.90. These four parts are separated by dots. IP has how many parts? Four parts. So Facebook will be having a different ID. Google, Yahoo, Amazon, every website is going to have a different IP address. So how to remember all these? That's very difficult to remember. What we are doing? We are typing only. We are typing our Google website, google.com, yahoo.com, that in our address bar. And we are visiting. But actually it is not like that. Yahoo.com, Google.com, all these .coms, all these websites are having an IP address. DNS is a system where these names, Amazon.com, Yahoo.com, these names are converted into IPs using what? Using a DNS system. Actually what happens is, We are a user here. We type amazon.com in address bar. That is what we are requesting. Our request will go to our web server, whoever is providing a service to our internet, that is ISP. It will go to that web server. Then how we typed that address? We typed in this way amazon.com. Then that amazon.com address will go to DNS server. Now this DNS server handles everything. What does this DNS server? DNS server converts, or DNS server knows what is the IP of amazon.com. Like that, many websites IP DNS server knows. It stores everything, it maintains everything. So it returns this IP address to our web server. After that, what happens? Our web server will send that IP address to our monitor screen, so we can see that website on our monitor or our desktop computer screen, or mobile also you can do that. Backend, whatever backend, backend means what? Whatever conversions are there, that will do that DNS server. DNS server is nothing but a domain name system server. It does everything for us. Understood? We'll see next now. Now we'll see about the internet protocol. I was telling IP. What is the IP? IP is a internet protocol. We'll see about that. Now see, internet protocol. An IP or IP address is a number used to indicate the location of the computer or other devices on a network using what? Using a TCP/IP. The TCP is nothing but a transmission control protocol. IP stands for internet protocol. What it does? It allows data to reach the appropriate destination on a network and the internet. Appropriate destination means what? We are sending mails, we are sending a postcard to our friends, relatives. There what you are writing? There you are writing to means to whom you want to send. And from who are sending that mail or postcard. Both these addresses very important. If any problem is there with two address, it will not reach to that person to whom we want to send that postcard or mail. This will be resolved over internet using a IP. IP is your computer's, your mobile's address over internet. What is IP? IP is your computer's or your mobile. If your mobile, your computer is connected to internet, that mobile's, that computer's address over internet is a IP. Transmission control protocol, that we will see later on. We will move next. Internet protocol we have seen, domain name system also we have seen. Now we will move to uniform resource locator. Uniform resource locator, here on screen you can see one address. I typed http://www.google.com. And downside I marked 1, 2, 3, 4. One by one we will discuss about this uniform resource locator, where we type this address. We type in address bar. Any browser, Internet Explorer, Opera you use or Chrome you use, in address bar we type this. First we will see about what is the HTTP. So let me click on number 1. Here HTTP is what? HTTP is a hypertext transfer protocol. What is a HTTP? HTTP is a hypertext transfer protocol. Next, www. Everyone knows www. What is a www? World Wide Web. World Wide Web. Then next is a Google. Everyone knows that. What is a Google? Google is a search engine. Google is a search engine. And last, that point is a .com. That last point is what? .com. That indicates a commercial website. .com indicates commercial website. Next we will see. Yes, here we will see about TLDs. Last part, our last part is a TLD. That is what? A top level domains. What are these top level domains? What this indicates? Top level domain is a part of a domain that comes after the dot. For example, .com we have seen, .org or .net. One by one we will see all these things. .com, the .com refers to a commercial website. If any website is having a later part, last part, having a .com indicates that website is a commercial website. Next, we have a .net, that is network website. .org indicates a non-profitable organization. Then .int indicates a international organization. Then .edu, edu, indicates a educational website. Then we have .gov. .gov indicates a government website. Then .mil, it is a used for military website. And lastly .gov.in. .gov we know already, government, and again that .in indicates a Indian government website. Like this we use a many TLDs day to day life. Today we covered 4 points. First, domain name system, then internet protocol, then uniform resource locator. Then lastly we covered about a top level domains. Guys, if you have any doubt about these things, you can comment in comment section. And if you like this video, please don't forget to hit like button and please subscribe our channel. Thank you.